So today I am going to a market, kind of like a shopper's market, where there's handmade jewelry, furniture, that type of stuff. So this is my fit of the day. Casual. It's like 60. I don't know if it's too hot or if it's too cold. So we'll see. But if not, I'll just take the jacket off. But yeah. Neighborhood called Roma Norte. This is cute. It's very colorful, very posh. It's cleaner. I definitely am more so in the business district, so it is much more city life. I think downtown Atlanta, and so this is more like Virginia Highlands, but better. So I think it's cute. I'm almost there. It says I'm like 2 minutes away. Boy, there you go. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so they all have different meanings. So what's one of them? Oh, okay. Okay. Oh, you said which ones? You said this is self-love.
Self-love. The orange and the pink ones. The blue ones are for communication, relax, health, and money.
Mm. It's tricky. Okay, I'm gonna get the orange. Tea or yogurt parfait.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
For tea, let me give you a try our biscuit honey.
Okay.
Amazing on tea. Very subtle taste. It will change the flavor of your tea. It will only enhance it.
It is very subtle.
Yeah. Also, it has a very low sugar in it. So even diabetics can use it. For your parfait, I will recommend you this one. This is our wildflower honey. Amazing on toast, yogurt, granola.
That's really good. How much are they?
We have each one on 200, or we do have the kit that you can take four, and it includes a honey spoon on 700.
I want to try this. I want to get the second one.
The second one?
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
I really didn't eat that honey, but it's actually pretty good. I'm gonna try and find a place over here for lunch. Okay. Oh, there's more? Hola. Oh my god, there's more. Hola. Spent plenty of money today. I got some fresh teas. Come on, focus. Focus. There we go. I got some fresh teas. I got some jewelry. I got a cute shirt. This is very successful. And they do this, I think, every other Saturday. So I'm going to check it out. This restaurant has a line. It must be good. I'm just going to keep walking. If I walk too far, I'll just take an Uber home. I'm gonna keep walking and see what I can find, because this is the area I should have been in. This is the area I was trying to be in, but it's expensive. I see why. Look at this. Just beautiful. That's a paid actor right there, baby. Morph markets. Hola. Oh, Amber would love this. And Destiny. Hola.
Hola, bienvenida. Elaboramos productos a base de cannabis.
No habla
edibles?
Oh, yeah, these are yes. Real edibles? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Is it legal here?
Consumo, sí.
Hmm. Okay. Sí.
Gracias.
Okay. Cool. Gracias.
Sí, a ti.
Cool restaurant right here. Let's see what they got. I had to take my jacket off because it was hot. I'm gonna trust my instincts and stop wearing jackets around the city. I don't know why everybody else has on a jacket, but I obviously do not need it. I'm sweating. So, we're gonna get some lunch. I gotta do the QR code, see what they got here. I don't even know what they got here. It just looked cute, and I was like, cool, let's come sit. So let's see. One thing I'm big on here, or any place in the world, if I don't get service within a certain amount of time, I'm walking out. Can't miss this, so you know I'm here. I get people 10 minutes, then I walk out. I had to stare someone down to come. I'm the only one up here. I won't say it's racism as much as it's just people don't want to try and speak English, but I want to learn Spanish. So,
hola.
Hola. So, yeah, I just want to learn Spanish. So, I want people to come to me so I could try, but don't, like, avoid me, because then I'm just going to leave.
Best.
What do you think?
Ooh, I love those.
Cool, no?
That's nice.
Yeah.
You look good. Look
Thank
good.
You. Thank you very much.
Okay, so it's going to be tomorrow around 3. Or let me know what time you're going and we can do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. Sunday. It's called Sunday Sunday, so you can check it out. But I noticed one of the DJs is like this German person that's really good.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to go for that DJ.
Okay.
So sometimes the minimal techno people play there.
Yeah.
Or the British como house people play there.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I'm into hearing new things too.
Mm-hmm.
See how other DJs do it. Because mm-hmm. I think the DJs in Atlanta have a vibe. So.
I love that vibe.
Yeah. Every city has something new.
Is Atlanta more like trappy?
It's a different mix. You have different sides. So you have kind of, yeah, the trap music, but then you also have house. Like, we like house music. And so we
do
house with electronic and hip-hop.
You would love, like, old school house, like
yes.
Chicago and all that, no?
Yeah.
Like Detroit.
Mm-hmm, yes.
I love that stuff.
Exactly.
Sometimes there's parties of that here. Sometimes.
Have you heard of Joe K?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really? Joe K does Selection. You should check them out. Selection, he has a radio station on SoundCloud.
Oh, that's cool.
They do like hour-long shows, but mm-hmm. he tours the world and does shows. But he's really good DJ. And I couldn't do it.
Do you find yourself as an emotionally accessible person?
Yes.
So do I?
Yes, but I know how to, like, you know, guard myself sometimes.
You have to.
Because some people want it when I'm not ready, or some people want it for their own benefit. Like, I've noticed a lot of people want to be around me for their benefit and not because they truly enjoy who I am as a person. And so, yeah, I experienced that a lot this year. I experienced that a lot. Because they're not real, you know? They're not real friends. They're not showing up for you.
Same.
That way, it's just, oh, you go to nice events. I want to go there, too. You know, like, so I'm very picky about my emotions. Because I am a very emotional person.
So am I.
And so
highly sensitive, I'm sure.
Huh?
You are highly sensitive, I can tell.
Very sensitive.
You're doing
it. And I'm okay with it. I used to think it was a bad thing.
Why?
But now I'm like...
Never.
I thought it was a bad thing because the people around me said it was a bad thing. You know, you're too sensitive, or, oh, you care too much about this.
Nah.
And I'm like, why don't you care? You know, why don't you feel this way?
Yeah.
And so I'm very passionate about certain things, and I am in this space now where I keep sensitive people around me. And honestly, also with that, when you aren't untapped with your emotions, and you don't want to get deep, I feel like you're hiding yourself. You know, like you're not being your true self. You know, because you're not opening up, you're not being honest. And that's a big one. Like, you don't have to be a liar to not be honest.
I like that.
You know? So...
I like what you said.
Yeah. Even though it's safe to walk at night, I think my American brain is just like, oh, I don't like this. I don't like this, but no one's bothering me. There's other women out here walking, but I can't. Looking over my shoulder, like, I'm not hip to it yet. Not hip to it yet. But I'll get there. But right now, while the sun's still out a little, I'm gonna get my ass home. I told y'all I was gonna lose my keys. I told y'all it was gonna happen. I knew it was gonna happen. So I think it was mixed up with my cash. And it fell out because I paid cash for everything at the market today. And when I got to my apartment, I got to the door and I was like, oh, fuck. So thank God I have a concierge and I could go talk to them. I think it's 7. It's like 7 something. So yeah, I'm glad that they're 24 hours because she got me a new one. But it cost me 500 pesos to get a new one, which isn't bad. But I was like, bro, just money. I spent so much money this week. So much money. And I know, like, the startup cost of moving is always a thing. But man, I was like, really? Really? So, yeah, I had to get a new one. And I asked, I was like, can I poke a hole in this? And they're like, no, Erica, no. I was like, I'm gonna lose it again. And they were like, good luck. So I might put it in my wallet, but I feel same thing, like I pull out a card. I don't know, but I'm gonna have to figure it out because I manifested it, I guess. I manifested it. But let's talk about Carlos. So I was dining somewhere. I don't even know what it was called. My eye is like really red. I lost some nail today. Bro, today's been a day. So I met Carlos while eating by myself. And he like kept looking at me. And so I knew he was gonna strike up conversation, and then he did. And so usually in these situations, I'm like, yeah, totally. And then, you know, drink my drink and go somewhere else. But today I was like, let's chat. But let me do this. You know, I moved for a reason. Let's do this. So we're chatting and we're talking from across the table. Like, we were facing each other, but at our own tables, which was also very awkward because usually I keep my back to people. So I think that's the other reason why, because it's like we're staring at each other. Let's talk. So after a while, I was like, can I just come over there and join you? And so I grabbed my drinks and my food and went over to his table to talk. So he is from Colombia and he's been in Mexico City for 10 years, he said. He is a musician. He is a producer, or not a producer, a composer and a singer. And so he actually has something tonight that he invited me to, and I couldn't find anything else to do tonight. So I was like, sure. I mean, I'm not going because I couldn't find anything else, but I was like, yeah, like, let's do it. So he's gonna put my name on the list so I can just get in there. And it was funny. He was like, you need to be there 10 sharp, like 10 sharp. And he was like, you look like someone who's on time. And I was like, you know it. I'll be there 15 minutes early, but I'm not driving, and that's the thing. So I probably should get dressed like right after this, because I don't know what the traffic is like this time of night. I know the traffic is really bad throughout the day, but I don't know what it's like at night. So we'll see. But we were talking, you know, he was telling me about Mexico, and I asked him about the gentrification going on in the city, and he's like, I don't have a problem with international people coming here. I have a problem with the Tuluminati. That's what he called it, the Tuluminati. So the Tuluminati are basically the white kids that come to Mexico just for the drugs, just for the parties. They're not really here to engage in the culture. They're not really here to get to know other people. They hang around only Americans. And it's running rampant. He said that, you know, they have like festivals. Oh my God. They have festivals here, like music festivals. Kendrick Lamar is coming in March, and he invited me to go. I was like, yes. So they have festivals, and the police have tested the cocaine here. 50% fentanyl. 50% in the cocaine. Another thing, people are doing ketamine. Ketamine, if you don't know what ketamine is, that's horse tranquilizers, okay? That's you know how big a horse is, and you're consuming that? Wild. Wild. Another thing that Carlos talked about was the dating scene here. Oh, that's too much. That is too much. He talked about the dating scene here, and he said that there is a machismo epidemic happening. And, you know, Mexican men are very machismo. They're not faithful. They lie a lot. And they're very possessive. They don't want you to date other people. And he says that when he was on Bumble, you know, all of the Mexican women were like, please don't be a liar. Please don't be a liar. Don't lie to me. Don't lie to me. In their profile. So he was like, yeah, you know, if you're going to date like non-Mexican men, date foreigners or, you know, yeah, other people, because the Mexican men are off the damn rails. They're off the rails. Which sucks because I just came from Atlanta, and Atlanta's garbage. It was garbage. And so I don't know. I'm not really interested in dating right now, I really want to focus on myself. And I'll be honest to say that men are a huge distraction. And I feel like when you were on your shit, on your stuff, I don't know, the YouTube lost it. But when you're on your shit, I feel like guys bother you more. Because they like that. They like that you're like doing things and ambitious and successful. And it's like, no, please leave me alone. I want to focus on myself. So, not shocked by that. Not shocked at all. I have to like look in different ways because this is too bright for me and this is not my skin color. I think I'm blended in. That's it. I don't shade girls who do a full makeup routine. I think it's really great. I can't do it. I can't do it. And I say like the way I do my makeup when I do a full face, I do look different. Not in a bad way or anything. I just don't look like myself fully. And I had a really bad time accepting myself in college. So, you know, like the Snapchat filters, all of that stuff really ruined my image of how I see myself. And so I went no makeup for a very long time. I think this is the first year I've gotten back into makeup, and it's concealer. That's all I do. Because I really, really love my face. Not saying that women who do full face of makeup don't love their face, but for me, doing a full face of makeup was connected to me not loving my face. And so now that I'm in this huge self-journey, self-love journey, I'm obsessed with myself. And so I try to keep it as simple as possible. But I have, like, you know, some dark marks. I've been using vitamin C to help. So, and I'm doing my sunscreen. So eventually it's going to go away. But in the meantime, I just like to cover this. I've had these glasses marks on my face since high school. Because I was wearing the metal frames. And then I was in the sun for track every day. And so I just have this permanent contour right here. And it's not necessarily my face. This is what my face would look like if all of my dark marks were gone. Yes, bitch. Yes. Okay, I gotta go get dressed.
La 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 la